Alright, hello everyone and welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Online, where today I'm just right outside of South Point, where in the previous episode we did the Grip of Madness quest with good old Sheogorath, and I did enjoy that quest so much. I gotta say, out of all the Elder Scrolls games, any quest with Sheogorath in it tends to be some of my favorites. They're glorious. They're just hilariously good times. But yes, in the last episode, we did also discover that we had another quest over in this area. I'm guessing it's something else for in South Point, or potentially something else in the countryside. I think there's like a cemetery right over there, so who knows? Maybe we'll be heading that way with Gold Angamar. So, hello!
I'm looking for work.
Oh, are you?
Anyone who needs a hauler?
But I could use someone to carry all my crap.
Taking down tents, packing them up, and hauling them where they need to be unpacked and pitched.
Right.
And don't say carnival. I'm done with carnivals.
Carnival? What do you mean?
I was working in the carnival near Elden Root.
There's a carnival near Elden Root?
With the owner, Sarandel, doesn't know what she's doing.
Oh, really?
We came all the way from the Somerset Isles, and now the performers can't put on their acts.
Oh, no. What's the problem?
I don't know the details. Look, Sarandel can tell you herself. Me? I'm done with that operation.
All right, well, thank you. I may go and check that out. So let's see, the Carnival Conundrum. That's a level 20 quest. Yeah, we're level 18. That shouldn't be too much of a problem. And that's over there. Let's see, we're over right here. Probably best just to head back to Haven and then ride our horse on over. Probably be the best. It looks like the closest of the three-way shrines. So let's do that. Just walk right over here and head on back to the port. Ah, righty. So, checking out a carnival today. I'm intrigued by this. I didn't know there was a carnival. I didn't even explore it over there. How in the world did I miss a carnival? That seems like something obvious you'd notice, but apparently not. So let's just jump on the horse and make our way. Now intrigued what sort of things the carnival will have for us. But I actually think, just so that I'm not sitting here riding my horse for a good few minutes, chatting and wasting airspace, I think I'm going to actually fast forward here until we get to the carnival, because, well, I did not expect for us to be going this far. I figured the quest would be nearby where that guy was. So yeah, I will bring you guys back in a sec. Okay, bringing you back, and I did see this when we were heading to Elden Root for a quest a while back, but I just figured it was some sort of little town or camp or something. I didn't think it would be a carnival, so hello, you must be Sarandel.
Please enjoy our attractions. I'm terribly sorry they're so limited at the moment.
And what, may I ask, is the problem?
I convinced my performers to come here, to spread high elf culture in these lands. Bring a little piece of Somerset to Grotwood, you see?
Yeah, I can't imagine that going too well.
Our magician's supplies are missing, and our storyteller's stories fell flat.
Okay, well, is there anything I can do about that?
None of us know the area well enough to resolve these matters. Now we're a carnival, with nothing but a fortune teller. Huzzah!
All right.
I'd gladly pay the coin provided by the Somerset Cultural Expansion Council to anyone who would help us put on the show.
The Somerset Cultural Expansion Council. That seems like a somewhat dreary council to be on, but all right, I'll see what I can do.
My performers can best explain their setbacks. Connor is our bug trainer, Norian, our storyteller, and Vindare the Magnificent is, well, she's magnificent.
Okay.
I have to describe her that way. It's in her contract.
It's quite the contract. All right, I'll ask them what they need to perform. So let's head to the Bug Wrangler. Seems like it should be straightforward, I hope. I'm guessing we'll just have to like collect some food or something for the bugs. Hello?
Look at them. Limbs so sluggish and carapaces dreadfully dull. When you've raised the shocks since they were pupae, it gnaws at your heart to see them so listless.
And what's wrong with the bugs?
They're having trouble managing the local grass. So I've put them on an all-hay diet. And the climate. It's more humid than they're used to in Somerset. If I didn't know any better, I'd say they were homesick.
Homesick bugs. Okay, is there anything that could help?
When they were younger, I'd grind mud crab eyes into paste and give it to them as a treat.
Okay, so we need to get mud crab eyes.
But nobody sells mud crab eyes. And I can't leave my shocks to fade away while I scour the coasts.
And what if I brought you mud crab eyes?
I would forever be in your debt, my friend. A dozen would be enough to go around if you wouldn't mind. And I won't mind if they're a little mashed when I get them. Saves me some work.
Fair enough. Okay, so we need to get this fella some mud crab eyes. Let's go and chat with the other two to see what they need. Probably easier than going back and forth. Hello, Norian.
I'm sorry, but I have nothing to say.
Serendel said you had a problem.
That is my problem. I literally have nothing to say to these people.
Interesting.
All my stories about the amazing deeds of long-dead high elves. The first rule of my profession is to know your audience.
And these are not high elves.
It's not a place to tell such tales.
And what tales did you plan to tell?
I planned to seek out wood elf stories in taverns and libraries. But since we arrived, I've heard of countless troubles in Grotwood. The worm cult, pirates, wood elf rebels. It's all the same. I'd rather keep to the safety of the carnival.
And if you can't leave, you can't find stories.
The wood elves rarely write their stories down. But I heard Scholar Glorolan in the Elden Root Mages Guild is the one to ask. If you're headed that way, would you mind asking for a book? It could be written in Old Akaviri for all I care. Anything would help.
Noted. All right, I'll see what I can find in Elden Root. All right, so we need to find Dark Elf stories for him. Or not Dark Elf, Wood Elves. The Dark Elves are a part of the Ebonheart Pack. That would be a little weird to find their stories here. But all right, hello, Vindari the Magnificent.
From far away, just to see Vindari the Magnificent. I am not performing at present. My magic cannot function safely in front of a crowd.
Can it not now?
Stars are out of alignment.
Yeah, sure they are. So Serendel said I should speak with you about your problem.
Oh, did she? Did she also tell you how she promised that would make 10 times our normal take by coming to this godforsaken backwater?
She did not.
Did she mention how she said shipping my supplies wouldn't be an issue?
And I'm guessing that they were an issue.
The shipping was fine. It's the delivery where it fell apart. My belongings arrived at the docks of Haven without incident. But due to the recent problems in the city, no one has any idea when deliveries will resume.
Oh, well, understandable. They did get attacked and, you know, taken over for a bit there. Okay, so your supplies are sitting on the docks then?
As far as I'm aware, yes. They're in the nicest looking trunk on the dock. I had it.
That's very presumptuous of you to say.
But with the pirate attack, who knows when Haven will be stable enough to deliver their backlog of shipments.
And what if I retrieved this trunk?
I couldn't ask you to lug that heavy monstrosity all the way here.
Oh, I'm sure you could.
It's triple reinforced steel with an inch thick lead interior discourages my competition from snooping. I just need the supplies inside, if you wouldn't
mind. Fair enough. Seems simple enough here, so I don't mind. I will retrieve them. And since Haven is on the coast, we should be able to find mud crabs over there as well. And the only pain... We can take care... Oh, he's telling me to go over there for the mud crab eyes? Why? When there's mud crabs over here. Oh well. There's also the issue of Elden Root. Well, you know what? I'm just going to spend some gold and travel to the Elden Root Way Shrine so we can just go right on up to the Mage's Guild there. I know it's a little bit of a waste of money considering it's not too far to take my horse, but... time is of the essence, and I don't want to waste it. So, load up Elden Root. Slowly. Come on, ESO. You can do it. Loading screens seem to be going oddly slow today. But, oh well, such is the way with MMOs most of the time. Oh, hey, quest over here. Did I see that quest last time I was here? I don't know. Oh well, up to the Mage's Guild we go. I do gotta say, I know I've said it before when we were here previously, but I do love Elden Root. It's just so beautiful in here. I mean, come on, look at that. It's glorious. And we just need to go up through those doors. I don't need to stop at the bank for anything, so...
Hello there.
Oh, hello, person who just spawned right in front of me. That was strange. But all right, Mage's Guild. And who is this person we need to talk to again? Scholar Glarolin? Upstairs or down? I'm guessing down? Yep, there we go. All right. Hello. How are you?
Yes, how can I help you?
I'm looking for a book on Wood Elf folklore.
My people mostly leave such matters to our spinners to share, rather than writing it down.
That's very inconvenient for me.
Something. But I can't imagine you'd want Nakaviri spy's writings on our heritage.
Ha!
Cultural infiltration document. Complete garbage.
Well, our customer did say he didn't mind if it was in ancient Akaviri, so I'll take it.
You read Akaviri?
No, I do not.
No matter. You're welcome to it. Let me see. I'll have a copy around here somewhere. A moment, please.
Righto. If you could just fetch that for me, please. And I hope the guy can actually read the Akaviri.
One flawed Akaviri depiction of my people.
Flawed? You sure? You sure about that? I mean, they were the Akaviri.
You found it as amusing as I did.
All right. Well, I'm sure I will. We'll just take that. This book is written entirely in Akaviri, purportedly about the heritage of the Wood Elf people. Well, just grab that and be on our way. Excellent, that is one part of the quest done already, and we're just a few minutes into it. Ah, good times, good times. Now, let's just make it back down to the Way Shrine and head on over to Haven. We should be able to grab the stuff from the docks fairly easily. And then I'm also going to check if we can still get the mud crab eyes from the mud crabs by the docks. It would be handy. Though with how many we need, I probably will have to make my way killing mud crabs anyways. Because, yeah. Sometimes it's annoying when you have to do quests like this to kill so many creatures to get what you need. Because they don't always drop what you need. Which is kind of strange. I mean, I'll bet you that every time we kill a mud crab, we may only get one eye. Possibly. Even though the mud crabs all have two eyes. I've never understood that part about games. They'll ask you to go kill a bear and get a bear pelt, but only like one out of three bears will drop the bear pelt. It's a bear. Its pelt is, you know, bear. But apparently not. All right, so we just need to make our way over to the docks. Okay, we can actually use our horse here. We couldn't indoors in Elden Root, but now that we are outdoors again, should be fine.
Hail.
Yes, hail to you as well, bag merchant. I actually need to go to that bag merchant later. I believe I have enough money in my bank to actually pick up a bag enhancement. That would be good. There's just never enough inventory space in games. I've got 90 on this character, and I run out of it quite quickly. And that's only thanks to the horse that we have that much inventory, but, you know, it's all good. It's all good. Okay, so we actually have to search for the supplies. Lovely, it won't just tell us. I'm guessing it's that, though, so it doesn't look like we had to search very far. It works for me. Hello, magical supplies. A combination of treated paper, smoke bombs, vials, and other assorted items. Lovely. And we will head off the docks over on that side and work our way down the coast killing mud crabs. That should get us enough mud crab eyes, I'm hoping. We'll have to see, though. Off we go. Mud crabs? Yes, mud crabs. Oh, I'm in the water, so I can't attack. And take crystal fragment. Oh, hey, we actually got two mud crab eyes. I'll be damned. Look at that. Maybe it won't take us too long after all. And thankfully, it appears that we won't actually have to make our way all the way over to where it's telling us the mud crab eyes are. And I'll be darned. It's actually giving us two mud crab eyes per mud crab. Huh. I guess I have to take back what I was saying about the games earlier. But typically in games, it does tend to be that way. Hello, Nereid. I'm going to avoid you because I don't want to deal with you. Even though it probably wouldn't be too much. Oh my god, we hit the mother load. We might be able to finish this quest right here. Got a lot of crabs. Nice. All right, let's loot. Oh, that's glorious. They actually are giving us two eyes per crab. That is great. Oh, that makes me so happy. You have no idea. And why did I go to heal? All right, just drain the mud crab. There we go. That's 10. Ooh, a chest. Nice. A little bit of extra. Oh, that one shot that crab. Nice. Okay. Mud crab eyes. We got them all. Well, that's far more simple than I thought it would be. Like I was saying with the earlier, usually those type of fetch quests, they only give you small amounts, and I was not paying enough attention to that pin. Oh well, I've got a crap load of picks. I think I've got a full stack on my character, two full stacks in my bank, and my other characters also have full stacks of them. Hey, you know what? Let's kill these near IDs anyways, just for the hell of it. And Atronach! I haven't used you yet this episode, and I need to. There we go. Yes, no, you're just gonna get killed by the Atronach. There we are. Lovely. Aww. See, I wasn't neglecting you, I just had to wait a little bit to get the opportunity. Aww, I should have dropped it on that whole lot of mud crabs. That would have been hilarious. Well, at least to me it would have been hilarious. Not for the mud crabs, though. But, oh well. My good old Atronach got used, at least, and that's all I care about. Love that guy. And Strangler. Take that. Oh, he used his little pull-me-forward thing. I have no idea what that's actually called. Some sort of vine grapple or something. Supple roots. Let's go over here. And Way Shrine. We can just head right back over to the carnival. Oh, though the ride over there. You know what? Let's actually check in here. Ah, yeah, it'd be easier to ride over. Oh, my. Problem with the slightly out-of-the-way quest. So, I think once again, I'm gonna pause the recording and, you know, fast forward until we reach back at the carnival so you don't have to watch my horse bobbing up and down for the next few minutes. See you in a sec. Alright, and we are back at the carnival, and let's go turn in these mud crab eyes to our bug-loving friend over here. Hello, Cornair. Can I talk? Hold on, there we go. Always difficult
good
to get him on a horse.
The mud crab eyes. Only if you have the time. I realize it's not the most glamorous request.
It really isn't, but I have them.
Would you look at that? Just the smell of the thing seems to have perked them up.
Really?
I'll
look at him go, yeah.
To motivate my little friends.
Okay, well.
A joke, everyone. They are completely harmless.
Are they? I don't believe you.
Move on back, Mike. That's our show, everyone.
Well, that was the show.
Friends here need a short rest before their next
That was kind of a sad show. Okay, well, if that's what you have on hand here at the carnival, that's a little disappointing. I have a feeling it glitched because it looked like someone else talked to him at the same time. But, alright, well, let's get off the horse to chat with this guy. And hello, Norian.
What do you have there? A book?
Indeed I do.
A book? It's written in Akaviri.
Hey, you said that was fine. If you can't read Akaviri, that's not my problem.
This is wonderful. Nobody here will be able to find the source of my stories if they're written in another language. My Akaviri is a bit stale, but I think I can manage. You're welcome to stay for my performance.
Yeah, sure, what the heck?
But the god of the forest was no fool. Approaching the dwindling, sickly wood elves and noting their grass-stained teeth, Ifrei offered them a deal. They would make a new deal, a fresh green pact, and the forest itself would always defend them. And so the wood elves accepted Ifrei's offer. The meat mandate defied Molag Bal's red pact, as did the bone and leather used to build their homes.
Molag
Bal's rage was great. He would repay the breaking of the red pact with the devouring of Gilvardel.
No, not Gilvardel!
Is a tale for another time.
All right, then. Another time. Excellent. So let's go chat with Vindari the Magnificent, and that was a completely failed jump. Nice. Hello again.
Do you have them? You have them, don't you? Oh, I shouldn't get my hopes up. They fell in the sea, didn't they? I knew it. I have the worst luck.
No. You're fine. Here are your supplies.
Wonderful. That's everything I need. Once Haven gets its act together, they can deliver an empty trunk. You're welcome to stay for the show. Sit wherever you like.
All right,
you
then.
You won't regret it. Unless you
have sure about that?
Performances, then you'll regret it.
Ah, all right. Well, we'll see. So let's go and watch the performance. Jump.
No. Release me.
Oh, no. She's in trouble. There's a Dremora.
One thing, foul creature.
What do you forget?
What might that be?
The people of Gratwood are closely tied to the forest itself, and you cannot withstand the might of the Green Pact.
So she's going with the Green Pact cliche thing. Okay.
This can't be happening.
It is.
The Green Pact isn't real.
It's
no, it is.
Kick you back into the pit from which you crawled.
And he's gone. Well,
everyone,
come on. Go poof.
Find your will to mine. Together we can banish him.
No, not back to oblivion.
Hey, there we go. All right. Well, this carnival kind of sucks.
Your help. We've banished the foul Dremora. Behold the might of the Green Pact. I hope everyone enjoyed the show.
Kind of didn't. It was a little cheesy, but hey, what are you going to do? They are high elves, after all. It's not like they're known for their entertainment and humor, etc. But yeah, that is going to be it for... Oh, wait, no, we actually have to turn in the quest. I was going to end it right there. I forgot that we actually have to collect our reward. I do want to get paid for all this. Hello, Sarindel.
Would you look at that line? We're drawing more people than in Auradon.
Really? I really didn't see that many more people, but okay, what will you do now?
We'll perform our hearts out. The Wood Elves will see there's more to the Somerset Isles than stuffy politicians.
Yeah, I wouldn't count on that.
If there's enough call for it, we may have new performances to share.
Yeah, I think I'll pass. But thanks, though. Thanks for the money and the item that I'll sell. But yeah, that is going to be it for this episode. One's a little iffy, but you know what? It was a little interesting. I didn't quite enjoy finding that there is a carnival out here. I'm wondering if perhaps in some sort of holiday thing, maybe this will get used for something. Would be interesting to see. But besides that, the bug show, that was kind of sad. The guy's stories, it was alright, not too bad, but he is working off of shaky source material. And the magnificent lady over here, she's not very good. Oh, they're doing it all over again. Oh, no, I don't need to watch that once more. But yeah, I hope you all have enjoyed this episode. And, of course, that you come back for the next. But until then, thank you for watching, my friends. And as always, have a good one.